2016 Forgotten Hills Syrah. Literally, Syrah is the reason that I came here to make wine. So what are we drinking? We're drinking a Syrah that is actually an estate vineyard. It's located on the eastern side of the valley. If you kind of look in the mountains when you leave the winery, this winery is basically right at the base of those mountains. And what it does is, it's actually a very cool spot. All of the cold air rolls out of the mountains and it just kind of sits right above Forgotten Hills. So what does that do? It allows us to retain acid in the wine. It allows us to make a very, very earthy wine. And more importantly, kind of one of the creeds of what we do here at Gramercy is we get to make a balanced wine. So how do we make this wine? So Brandon, with the third man, had talked about whole cluster fermentation. So Syrah, we always have a portion of whole cluster fermentation. With this wine, it's about 75%. We kind of taste the stems and look at the stems to decide exactly how much we're going to have. So it's kind of like making a steak. If we put too much salt, we're not going to like the steak. If we don't have enough, the steak isn't going to taste right. So we're trying to get that exact same correct balance of stems to wine. So after we ferment the wine on its stems, we age it, again, in these 20 hectoliter Stockinger barrels. Syrah loves big barrels. If we have the same wine in a big barrel versus a small barrel, I guarantee that you're going to like what the big barrel tastes like the most. They stay in that barrel for about 17 months. So I'm not looking for oak flavor. These barrels are not giving us oak flavor. It's basically just giving us oxygen, which allows the wine to age, and more importantly, just decrease the tannins a little bit. So flavors for Syrah, I'm looking for red fruits, cranberries, strawberries, raspberries, and basically Texas barbecue in a glass. Smoked pepper, Italian charcuterie, smoked beef brisket. One of the parts of Forgotten Hills that we haven't talked about so far in any of our wines is what we call clones. With winemaking, we have grapes like Syrah and Cabernet, but within that family, there are what we call different clones, which actually give you different flavors. And the clones will have different aspects to them. Sometimes the berries will be small, sometimes the berries will be big, the cluster might be very tight, the cluster might be very loose. But the idea behind it is we're using the same variety, but we're getting slightly different flavors. And when you blend these together, you get a more complete, more interesting wine. So this wine is actually made from two different clones, what we call the Joseph Phelps clone, which was originally taken from the northern part of the Rhone Valley by Joseph Phelps himself and brought to the Napa Valley and has gone all over the United States. And then what we call clone 99, which reportedly is from the town of Hermitage, or the village of Hermitage in the Rhone, and brought to the United States. They're both here in Washington State, and we find that they give different profile to the wine, and we blend them together. It makes a complete Syrah, exactly what we're looking for.